Hello everyone, welcome to this video on how to integrate the report viewer control with the .NET 7 Blazor Server application to display the sales order detail report. You need to set two items to render RDL reports in the Blazor Server report viewer. They are reporting service. This API is used to interact with server-side report processing. Report path. This API is used to set the path of the report that will be rendered. We'll start by setting up a new Blazor Server project in Visual Studio Code, and then add the report viewer control to it. I have already installed the .NET 7 SDK on my machine. First, I need to create a new Blazor Server application. In the command prompt, I run this command. Here, Blazor Report Viewer is the application's name. Once the application is created, we need to install the NuGet packages. So, I change the current working directory to the application root folder. Then, add the boldreports.net.core package to the application. In the same way, add the microsoft.aspnet.core.mvc.newton.soft.json package to the application. This package version should be higher than 3.1.2. Now, let me initialize the report viewer. I open the application in Visual Studio Code. In this section, I will integrate JavaScript controls by creating an interop file to initialize the report viewer with basic parameters. Create a class file named boldReportViewerOptions.cs in the data folder. Add the code to hold the RDL report rendering properties. I create a folder named scripts in the www root folder and a boldReportsInterop.js file in the scripts folder. Then, add the code to invoke the JavaScript control. Inside the control, I assign values for report path and report service URL. Now, reference scripts and the stylesheet. Here, I am using CDN links to reference the scripts and stylesheet. You can also use local scripts and themes. I have included an FAQ link about using them in the description. Next, open the host.cshtml page from the pages folder. Then, copy the code from the documentation and add the online CDN links with the boldReportsInterop.js interop file to use the JavaScript reporting controls in the head tag. Next, I create a folder named resources in the www root folder. This is where RDL reports are stored. Let me add the salesorderdetail.rdl file to the resources folder. You will find the salesorderdetail.rdl file link in this video's description. Now, I'll configure the web API. The Blazor app requires a web API service to render the report viewer control. Create a new file and name it reportviewercontroller.cs file in the data folder. In that file, add all the necessary using statements for referencing and classes and namespaces defined within these namespaces. Next, add the namespace as blazorReportViewer.data to avoid naming conflicts. Inside that, add the root attribute for the report viewer controller. Add the class and inherit controller base and iReportController. The iReportController interface has a declaration of action methods required in the web API controller for processing reports and handling resource requests. Use the iHosting environment interface by importing the Microsoft.ASP.NET Core.Hosting namespace and injecting it through dependency injection to read the report file from the application. Next, I add the getResource method to get images to be used in the report from the server at the time of preview in the designer. Then I add the onInitReportOptions method invoked from a report helper when the report is about to be processed at the time of preview. Inside the method, I need to load the report as a stream. To do that, I create a variable named basePath and assign the folder path value with the report. Then, I combine the basePath with the report path sent from the index.razor file. Next, I create an instance for the file stream and assign the file path to it. And create the memory stream and copy the file stream value to it. Then, assign the report stream value to the report option.reportModel.stream variable. Next, I add the onReportLoaded method invoked from a report helper when the report and subreport start loading for report rendering. Then, add the postform report action to save the exported report to the client using the HTTP post action. Now, add the postReportAction method to process the report request on the server side and return the processed reporting result to the client side using the HTTP post action. The report helper class contains helper methods to process the request on the server side and return the response to the report viewer control. The getResource method returns the report resource to the requested key. The processReport method processes the report request and returns the result. Next, open the index.razor file from the pages folder. Here, inject IJS runtime and invoke this JavaScript interop with the created report viewer URL in the index.razor file. This is used to view reports. I have added the Blazor report viewer.data namespace. Here, Blazor report viewer is the name of the Blazor application. The div element represents the container. Inside the div element, I assign the ID and style attributes. The ID attribute specifies the unique name for the HTML element, and I assign a value to the report viewer. The style attribute is used to add the inline style for the div element, and I assign width and height. Inside it code, I create an object to access the bold report viewer options class. And initialize the render report viewer method. This method renders the bold report viewer control in the Blazor page. To this method, I add the report path and report service URL values. I enter the invoke void async method, which invokes the render viewer JavaScript function asynchronously. Then, I enter the onAfterRender method for the initial rendering of the control. Next, open the program.cs file and invoke the app.map controllers to map routes and actions, allowing the application to respond to HTTP requests made to controllers. Next, I register the license token to remove the license validation message. In this demo, I am going to use the online license token. License tokens can be generated in the subscription section of the Bold Reports Accounts page. In the program.cs file, enter the code snippet to register the token. I have provided the link on registering a license using online license tokens and offline license keys in this video's description. Now, everything is set to preview the report. I open the command prompt and build the application. Then, I copy this URL and run it in a browser. See, the sales order detail report is loaded in the report viewer. In this video, I have shown you the steps to integrate the report viewer control to display the sales order detail in a Blazor server application using Visual Studio Code. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.